Bhagwan Vamana. Parikshit asked sage Shuka, why did the Supreme Lord Lakshmipati, the possessor of all wealth, who is ever full, immovable and without desires, approach another person and beg for a space of 3 feet, as if he was in distress, without any cause or offense? Why did he bind over the emperor Bali? I am eager to know. Sage Shuka replied, Bali, having been killed by Indra, got back to life by the grace of his guru Shukracharya. So he served the guru with very great devotion. The guru was much pleased with him and had a sacrifice called Vishwajit Yaga, performed by Bali strictly as per regulations. The fire god Agni was pleased to bestow on Bali a golden chariot with special horses, a flag, armor, good bow, and 2 quivers of arrows. His grandfather Prahlada gave him a garland. His guru gave him a conch. Bali used to worship all elders, gurus and Brahmins, and so he shone forth with noble virtues. As time went on, he developed great vigor, and so he decided to attack Indra and besieged his capital. Indra wondered as to how this fellow, who was actually dead in the battlefield and whose party was routed out, could have dared to attack him again with such vehemence and power. How did he gain such prosperity? The preceptor of the gods, Brihaspati, explained to him that Bali had acquired great merit by the worship of his guru and Brahmins, and that in his present state he could not be faced and defeated by Indra or other gods, except by the Supreme Lord. He was then in ascendance. He would have a fall by disrespecting them. Till then, Indra and his followers were advised to make a quick exit and hide themselves from his sight. Indra did accordingly. The capital, Amaravati, was vacant. Bali entered it and made it his seat of sovereignty and ruled over the 3 worlds. His guru Shukra made him perform 100 horse sacrifices to propitiate the Lord. In his kingdom, there were no beggars. All projects of development were successful. Brahmins were living a contented life. Rains were timely. The earth was yielding plenty of crops. Aditi, mother of the gods, reported to her husband, Kashyapa Brahma, the fate of her children being exiled from their kingdom. He heard her patiently and meditated for some time. He looked at the future through intuition. He asked his wife to pray to the Supreme earnestly, adopting the Payovrata, which he taught her incidentally. She did so. The Lord was pleased with her and promised to redress all her grievances and bring back prosperity to her children, the gods. He told her that he would be born to her as a son and requested her to rear him up with love, and that Bali could not be put down by force nor immediately. At a very auspicious moment, Aditi gave birth to a son, a dwarf, short in stature and resplendent in features. As soon as the boy was initiated into the Gayatri Mantra, Upanayana, he started from home with a Kamandalu, Kaupina and Bhikshapatra for pilgrimage. Having heard of the great many sacrifices and immense charity of the Emperor Bali, he reached his Yajnashala on the banks of the sacred river Narmada. He entered the assembly, began to converse with the Brahmins and priests one after another on grammar, poetry, Vedas and Upanishads and Karmakanda. He slowly pushed forward and went very near the emperor. Shukracharya and others received him with due respect. Bali washed his feet and gave him a seat of honor and inquired of him as follows, O Brahmin, I presume you have come to receive some gift from me. Please let me know your wish. May I give you fruits, clothes, money, gold, precious stones, horses, elephants, vehicle, houses, villages, fields, kingdom? What will you ask for? Bhagavan Vamana replied, You have spoken nice words of welcome. It shows that you are highly cultured. Shukracharya guides you right on the material side and Prahlada on the spiritual side. I have heard of your greatness in charity. I am a brahmachari and I am single. I cannot point out which is my abode and which is not. I have no relations. I move about with everybody. I need no help from others, but I will be helping all. I move in the three spheres. I know this, that and everything. I had wealth from the beginning. I always live with the wise. You have ruled over the three worlds. You have driven away the gods. You have made big charities. The demons thrive well under you. You have offered to give me some gift. It would be insulting to refuse the offer. I am but one and single. I am not in need of great things. I would require only 3 feet of space. Just enough to rest on, which if you give, I will consider it as equal to having the three worlds. Bali said, O Brahmin, you are speaking the simple truth. Indeed, they are pregnant with a deep meaning. But you have asked for very little. Should you not ask for something which will enhance the greatness of the donor? Could you not ask for kingdom, elephants, brides? You are too young to decide and do not know which to ask for. Am I to give you only space for 3 feet as a great charity? Bhagwan said, What more does a brahmachari want and what for? If a man is not satisfied with what chance has provided for him, he will never be happy even if he gets the 7 continents. For desires have no end. Emperors have conquered countries. Empires have come and gone, but were the emperors satisfied? Where are they now? What I have asked for is more than enough if you give it with your full heart. Meanwhile, Shukracharya warned Bali, O king, this is not a Brahmin boy. He is the Lord Vishnu himself come in disguise. You will perish if you give him the gift asked for by him. He will occupy the 3 worlds. Bind you and drive you out. Beware. Bali said in reply, Be it so. It is my good fortune to give a gift to the Lord. Who will get such a chance? If he binds me and drives me out, I will take it with pleasure. Why will he do so? I cannot withdraw my word. I stand for honor and not the kingdom. Shukracharya got wild as Bali was not listening to his words and cursed him that he would lose his kingdom where long Bali heard it. He calmly proceeded with his decision. His wife assisted him to drop water in his hands as a token of giving the gift. There was universal acclamation for his sacrifice, his gift and steadfastness in his purpose. For he had acted as per the injunctions of the Upanishads, which say, Shraddhaya Deyam, Ashraddhaya Adeyam, Shriyaya Deyam, Hriyaya Deyam, Bhya Deyam, Samvida Deyam. One must give with earnestness and steadfastness. Half-hearted charity is a source of evil. One must be possessed of plenty of wealth and then desire to give. A pauper cannot help anybody. With humility one must give. Because whose is the property? Kasyasvidhanam. The Supreme bestows and gives the capacity to give out of his gift. One must give with fear of his own conduct and see how far he is following the rules of righteousness. One must not be arrogant in giving. One must give with full knowledge of his capacity, the capacity of the receiver, the quantity that is being given, and how far it is going to fulfill the purpose of the gift. One must not give and later feel sorry that he has given more than his capacity. All these pros and cons must precede the act of giving. Bali did so. He knew that he had the three worlds in his command. He knew the receiver was the Lord. He knew the Lord would do him only good for doing a good act and not harm him. With full confidence, he gave and stands with an everlasting name in the history of the world as the one who gave his all at a proper time, in a proper place, and to the proper recipient. Having received the gift, the Lord expanded his form and stretched one of his foot over the whole earth, and with the other foot he covered the sky and all the space that could be imagined as existing. In this, his transcendental form, Bali and all the others could see the earth, the sky, the four directions, the subterranean regions, the seven oceans, all the living creatures, human beings, gods, rishis, Bali and his Yajnashala, Prakriti with the three gunas, the five elements, the indriyas, the sense objects, the mind, the jivas, Vishnu, Lakshmi, the sun, moon, all the Vedas, all the celestial worlds, and there was not an atom of space available anywhere to place a third foot of his. All the gods, rishis and human beings began to praise the Lord for his victory and for his long strides. Jambavan, the old bear of Ramayana, ran round the world with Tom Tom proclaiming the Lord's victory. Victory to Lord Vishnu! The demon followers of Bali got angry at the Lord, coming in disguise and robbing away the kingdom of Bali, their emperor, and they tried to attack him. The gods stood up to put them down. Bali requested the demons to have patience, as it was bad time for the demons. They were asked to bow down till better times dawned for them. Bhagavan Vamana turned to Bali and said that what all he could give as gift was just enough for his 2 feet. He asked, "Where is the space for my third foot? If you cannot show some space for it, your gift becomes defective and your word a lie." Bali very calmly replied, "Lord, I cannot stoop to be a liar. Please place your foot on my head, which I consider as more sacred than my kingdom. It will be all for my shreyas, prosperity. You have destroyed my arrogance, opened my eyes for a divine outlook. You have shown me the path followed by my grandfather Prahlada, the way to liberation. I am grateful to you." Meanwhile, Prahlada appeared on the scene and praised the Lord, for he gave Bali the greatness to rise and he had done him good by depriving him of the same. This was a great act of mercy, showing the way to liberation. Bali's wife, Vindhyavali, praised the Lord and begged for Patibhiksha, the safe return to her husband. Brahma also praised the Lord for his victory and for showing the right road to Bali. The Lord said, "Bali has conquered my Maya, for he was not unnerved with all the deprivations and curses of his guru or for the loss of his fame. He was fully established in knowledge, so he will thrive under my protection in the subterranean regions called the Sutala and rule over the demons and others." Then Prahlada and Bali with their followers prostrated before the Lord and retired to Sutala. Bhagavan Vamana chastised Shukracharya for his evil directions to Bali, reprimanded and advised him to follow the path of righteousness. Then Bhagavan Vamana, having been born to Aditi as the younger brother of Indra, handed over the heavens to Indra and advised him to rule over the gods with due devotion to him, Lord Vishnu.